Dave, but the same story on the market, Julia. What did you make of the session today?
It was hard to read anything into the market today. We did see an extremely light session with just $2.5 billion worth of stock being traded. And just comparing that to some of the volumes that we're used to, last year in the month of November, the average volume per day was $4.4 billion worth of stock being traded. We're in the last week of November, and this year we're averaging $3.6 billion this month. So it's down by around about 18%, some very light volumes going through the market. Now, today was a special one because, of course, on Friday we did see a half trading day in the US for the Black Friday shopping day, and we did see the US with a pretty good performance, up by 1.3%. But I think the market really waiting on this decision around Greece. This is the third time that the Eurozone has come to an agreement in the last 2 weeks. Now, this is to release 31.2 billion euros worth of cash, and Greece has been really waiting for this since June. It's part of the 130 billion euro bailout which was agreed upon earlier on in the year. So we're really watching this, because if an agreement can't be made on Monday, then there have been some reports that we might have to wait for the official Eurozone meeting on the 3rd of December. So all eyes on Greece. In terms of trading today, though, the standouts today were the utility space as the industrial space. So no clear trends on the market, but an extremely light trading day.
Individual stocks today, Julian. I wanted to get your thoughts on Shopping Centres Australia. Of course, the IPO spun off out of Westfield. A pretty positive debut.
It was a good one, and this is the biggest IPO that we've seen for 2012 so far. So it's nice to see that on the first day of trading that we have seen SCA Property actually trading above the IPO price. Now, if we have a look at this particular IPO, this has come out of Woolworths. It's a property portfolio, 69 portfolios, valued at about $1.4 billion. And I guess that's good news for Woolies shareholders. It means they can separate out the supermarket business out from the property side of the business. If we have a look at how these two areas have traded throughout 2012 in the last year, the staples area is up by 17%, and the property area has been doing pretty well as well, up by 23%. So both areas have been doing relatively well. Property has outperformed a little bit. If we have a look at the IPO price, it was $1.40. Now, the guide that Woolies gave was between $1.26 to $1.50, so a little bit on the higher end of those expectations. And if we have a look at how the shares traded today, this is the intraday graph for SCA Property. SCP is the code. $1.40 is the price, and we didn't see that IPO price being hit once today, so that's a positive sign. And you can see as the day progressed, we just saw the share price rising. So altogether, a pretty successful debut for SCA Property on the market. This is after just over $470 million was raised last Thursday through the institutional component of this raising. We'll also see the retail component of this raising, and of course existing Woolies shareholders will receive one share for every five that they own.
When we spoke about Challenger, and I sort of asked, well, it's very good at the moment in uncertain times, people looking for that sort of annuity exposure, but if the market, you know, corrects and we start getting sustainable sort of gains, then people might not sort of look for that certainty.
And I guess that's the cyclical side of things. And if we have a look at the cyclical side of things, we have seen annuity-style businesses doing very well, whereas equity volumes have struggled. But on the flip side, we're seeing also a structural shift, and that's because of the demographics of Australia, where we are seeing the baby boomer generation moving into retirement. And that's a structural shift that's really going to help to support this area, not only over the next decade, but probably over the next couple of decades. And that's really what Challenger pointed to in its AGM, the trends that we're going to see in this area, which should help to support its very strong annuity business. It's come back out to reconfirm its four-year guidance, so expecting to see its retail annuity business growing by 15% and the retail life book growing by 10%. And it's also come out with a share buyback, so buying back about $50 million worth of shares. So Challenger Financial Group doing pretty well today. It was up more than 2% at one stage, but by the end of the session up by 0.9%. So yes, at some stage we probably will see the cycle turn against Challenger. It has been winning in this uncertain environment, but I think we will start to see the structural trends coming into play here, and that should be supportive of Challenger's business and products.